Hello guys, so in this little video I want to give you an overview of the TDC, because it might look a bit overwhelming at first glance, but it's actually not that complicated. Alright, so on the left side of this panel there are six settings that you can adjust. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So you can't change everything here, it's just those six things. Alright, the first thing is the bearing selection. The bearing is basically, or this needle here, represents your periscope. So if we see the enemy to our right, 90 degrees, through our periscope, we would have to set the bearing to 90 degrees. Now for the most of the time you will simply link this device to your periscope. How do you do that? Well, you just switch angle tracking to attack periscope, and now, wait a second, so look at that. The bearing selector is linked to my attack periscope. Now if I look through the periscope now and look to the right, 90 degrees, it will change the setting here. Looking to the right, I'm leaving the periscope, and look, the bearing has just changed. So you don't have to bother about this anymore. Okay, next thing is the target speed, pretty straightforward. Just the speed of your enemy in knots. You have to find that out or calculate that. I'll do this later. Next thing is the range. Straightforward. It's just the range of your enemy in hectometers. So if you set this to 5 hectometers, that would mean that your enemy is 500 meters away. Alright. Again, you have to find it out. I will show you in a second, but we'll go through everything first. Alright, the angle on bow. That's where it gets a bit tricky. You can think of it this way. This needle here represents the imaginary periscope of your enemy's ship. So, if your enemy's ship is going this way and would see you through his imaginary periscope to the right, he would set this, he would set the angle on bow to 90 degrees right. I'm gonna repeat this. This needle represents the imaginary periscope of your enemy's ship. If your enemy sees you to his right, 90 degrees, you have to set the angle on bow to 90 degrees right. If we were right behind the enemy and the enemy would see us right behind himself, we would have to set this to 180 degrees. I hope that makes sense. Alright, let's move on. Torpedo depth, pretty straightforward. You set how low the torpedoes are supposed to go, below the water. And if you have identified a ship and you look at draught, that means that the ship is going 5 meters below the sea level, and so you could set this up to 5 meters, however not lower, because then you won't hit. The lower you set the value, the more damage you get. If you're starting out and you're just training to hit the enemy, you can just leave it at a very high setting, you can't do anything wrong. Alright, the length, again, that's your ship's length. If you identified your enemy ship, you can find the information here. This one has 150 meters of length. This setting is only relevant if you choose to perform a salvo shot. But because you need the length to determine, or for the most of the time need the length to determine the target speed, you can just set it here anyway to remind you of the length of the enemy ship. Alright, so bearing, target speed, range, angle on bow, torpedo depth, and length. One side note before I move on to the right side. If you change the bearing, let's switch this back to manual, look that the angle on bow is linked to the bearing selector. That means that you have to focus on the enemy first through your periscope. Let's say you see the enemy to your right and focus on it, and then select the angle on bow. Okay, focus on the enemy first, then select the angle on bow, because if you change the bearing later on, it will automatically update the angle on bow. All right, I already talked about this one. Let's set this back to attack periscope. Now the bearing selector is linked or slaved to our attack periscope. Here you can select the tube, obviously, or you select a salvo, and then you select this kind of salvo. Here you see your total amounts of torpedoes and the loaded slots here, and a time to impact with the current settings. All right, now let's have a look through the periscope. Oh, that looks like a good enemy. Okay, let's try it out. Let's open the recognition manual and merchants. I did another video about that. The engine is aft. Superstructure is split again. Islands is front and middle. And the mast code is mast funnel. MMMF. And it is this guy here, if you look at this mast. So let's check how high the mast is. It is 35 meters. Now let's find out the range of the enemy. I'm gonna zoom in and measure. You know what? Let's measure the funnel. The funnel is 22 meters. So I'm going to measure the funnel. It's 6 centiradians, if you see that here. Now I can open the distance table. And 6 centiradians, and the funnel was 22 meters high. So the range of the enemy is about 14.7 hectometers. Okay, we got the range. Now let's measure the speed. I'm gonna aim here and start the timer. And now we will measure the time the boat needs to travel the distance of its own length. I hope that makes sense. Get a calculator. Right, let's say it is, well, let's say 58 seconds. Identified ships. So the length is 124 divided by 58 seconds is the speed in meters per second, and if I multiply this by 2, I get 4.3 knots. Okay, so I'm gonna select a speed of 4.3 knots. Now, let's look at the angle on bow. It looks pretty good. The enemy sees us to his left, but we're already like 15 degrees, that would be our left. We're already about 15 degrees away, so I'm gonna choose this setting. Okay, the length was 124. It's not relevant because we're not doing a salvo shot, but I just do it here. Draught is 7, so we can select a lower value here, 5 meters. And we got the speed, the range, the angle on bow, and the torpedo depth. Alright, let's check if the angle on bow is right. I think it is. And let's try it out. Time to impact is 1:44. Now I could open the map and see how well we calculated. 4.1 knots, that's approximately what I got. The range, we set the range to 15, and here it's 14 hectometers, so it's about right. Angle on bow is 95, and we set it to, yeah, it's a bit, angle on bow is not quite right. That's the hardest part to estimate. I'm gonna cheat now and select another value and perform one shot and let's see. Maybe this one still hits. We'll see. Doesn't look too bad, but probably will. It will be very. Let's see if we hit the target without. Would have hit the target without cheating. Don't go too fast. Really thrilling if you hunting down an enemy all the time. That's only the tutorial, and then it's so thrilling to know if it hits or not. I hope that video helped you to get an idea how it works. So what about the second one? Didn't update the timer. So that's another good example on how the angle on bow works. The ship is going this way, and through the enemy ship's perspective, or through the enemy ship's imaginary periscope, the enemy would see us at an angle of 104 degrees. That's the angle on bow. No, it looks like it's going right into the middle. That's the one. The cheating one. Yeah, right in the middle. Alright, thanks for watching. The tutorial is a very good way to practice how those things work, and I hope I could give you an idea how it works. Thanks for watching, and goodbye.